Hey guys, so today I wanted to talk about surviving during lockdown. The biggest thing we hear a lot when it comes to lockdown survival is how important it is to keep a good schedule. And I do think that this is the case, but you also need to remember that there might be some bumps in the road when it comes to figuring out what works best for you. So don't beat yourself up about it. Just try figuring out what you like, what helps you to be the most productive, the most healthy, and the most happy. Next, of course, we have to monitor how much we're actually going out and about in the world, but never underestimate how much it helps to go outside and get moving, whether you go for a walk in the park, whether you go find some walking trails and just sort of explore and see where they go. If you don't really know what to do, or if you're feeling a bit upset or anxious, just taking a little bit to go for a walk is honestly a wonderful way to just sort of reboot your system and have a moment to relax and clear your head a bit. Another thing that I would recommend is tidying up your space. This is something that's been a New Year's resolution of mine to declutter my area around me a little bit, but having things organized and tidy is such a wonderful way to be more comfortable in the space that you're in and also to clear your head and be more efficient in the things that you do as well. And I've also been using this time to dig into my hobbies a little bit more. One thing that I didn't do as much before the pandemic was read. I really love to read, but I found that I never really had the time. And now that I'm at home some more, I've been able to dig into some of the books that I've had in my collection. I've also been able to work on my writing. I've been able to listen to podcasts and knit and bake. And there are just so many nice things you can do to fill the time, especially when you kind of get used to doing the same thing. Doing something to shake up your schedule a little bit can be nice. I know that might make it sound like I'm contradicting what I said, but we can have a schedule but still have room for spontaneity as well. And lastly, it's so important to take care of your mental health during this time. It's not really easy to endure lockdown without having some difficulties coping. So if you need someone to talk to, you can talk to friends, you can talk to family, you can talk to classmates, roommates, or professors, and there are so many incredible online resources available if you need help during this time. So please do take advantage of that. Please take care of yourself and be kind to yourself.